except the realtor takes us to see some houses in our price range. I'm a city man. The market is hot. The really desirable houses, the ones in cool neighborhoods with exciting architectural details, don't stay on the market for very long. Some of them are gone within hours. Which means the ones left over are the ones you have to grow to love. The weirdos, the clunkers, the blands. One thing I noticed is that every house has a Hawkeye room. This is a college town, home to the University of Iowa, whose mascot is Herky, the Hawkeye, a big fierce bird, and whose colors are black and gold. Some residents of this town have really taken that iconography to heart. Black and gold as a color palette, while striking, is not an obvious candidate for interior design. And yet, in the basement that looks like Herky the Hawkeye was brutally murdered. And his entrails, his black and gold entrails, for he bleeds black and gold, I have been assured by numerous t-shirts, have been spattered across the walls, the floor, the furniture. There are black and gold tiled floors, black and gold wallpaper, toilet seats featuring our rival, the Iowa State Cyclones. The colors are red and gold, a drop of bloody crimson in the carnage. We are not sports fans. And we can get a little snobby about it, which I understand is kind of obnoxious. At one point, Chris says, "What's with all the Hawkeye stuff? It's so tacky." And the blood drains from Chet's face. "You don't like the Hawkeyes?" And Chris backpedals furiously. "Oh, I mean, no Hawks." You can see the calculations in Chet's head. The fighting words. Whether the money he stands to make off us is worth brooking the insult. Before he stands down. Crisis averted. Chet's a good guy. But I don't think he gets us. We can be a little quirky. But quirky is not Chet's natural language. He takes us to see a house in North Liberty, which is a west side suburb. It's a nice house. They're all nice houses out in North Liberty. This one has a really tiny backyard, most of which is taken up by this giant trampoline. You know they make trampolines these days with 4-foot high nets? It's like a trampoline the size of a spaceship. So we're standing on the deck looking at this giant trampoline surrounded by a chain link fence. And I notice the house on the left has in its tiny yard a giant trampoline surrounded by a chain link fence. And the house on the right also has a tiny yard. And in it is a giant trampoline surrounded by a chain link fence. So I say, "Oh, I get it. In North Liberty, you get a free trampoline with purchase." And Chris laughs, and Chet can't tell if I'm joking. He's looking at the sales sheet going, "It doesn't say here that it comes with a trampoline. But if you're interested, we could negotiate." The houses Chet shows us are hilarious. Everybody knows that charming means small, but there's more to it. Well-maintained means it's old, but not awful. A good opportunity means it's a dump. A fine investment means it's a dump where somebody has stolen the toilet. These are the leftover houses that nobody's bought yet. Some of them have been on the market for months. Chet gives us a list and asks us to choose which ones we want to go see in person. We give them nicknames to keep them straight in our minds. Okay, so this one is the grandma house, because what probably happened is like grandma kicked it, and now like her kids are trying to get rid of her horrible house. No, see, look, we can play a game. It's called, how many crucifixes can you find in the grandma house? 1, 2, 3, 4. That was the scariest crucifix I've ever seen. Was grandma afraid of vampires? A little bit. Oh, come on! I was raised in the Catholic Church. I am no stranger to a gory crucifix. This crucifix looks like a weapon. I don't want to see this house. It looks horrible. Pass. Ooh, now this one we should go see. The Brady Bunch house. And yes, I do feel I have time traveled into the 1970s. Sunken living room, glorious. Oh no, that's not a green sink, darling. It's avocado. I kind of love it. It's fabulous and it's kitsch. Huh. The basement has clearly belonged to a serial killer. Park in this driveway. It's like the driveway can only accommodate 3/4 of a regular car. Okay, stone house, round door.
Chris,
it's a hobbit house. Wait, who am I? You have my sword, Frodo! Nervous. I think it's easy for it. If we stay here too long, we might actually want to buy it. But we can't buy it. We're not Hobbit House people anymore. Actually, we ever were. But we're not suburban trampoline people either. Or Brady Bunch people, or Grandma House people. Who are we? Are we the kind of people who would live on a cul-de-sac?